Hello. Welcome back to Farming Simulator 22. Let's play White Farm. I'm your host, Fields and Skylines. It is July, and as you can see, I'm just finishing up feeding the cows. Busy farm today. Lots going on. Setting up for an oat harvest. We have 3 fields of grass that needs mowing. In fact, we have a worker out on fields right now as we speak. So we have to get all of that done. We have field. We'll have 2 fields that need mulching. And then we will also have to do some other work. But what else do we need to do? That's about it. That's what we got to do. That's all we have to do. Mow 3 fields, figure out hay and silage ratio, harvest some oats, mulch a barley and the oat field, all in this month. So we've been cracking on. We'll get cracked on. I'm going to get the harvester over to the oat field, set up. Then we'll check on our AI worker, and then we'll probably kick off into the oat harvest. Spend most of my time on that. We don't get to see as much harvesting as we do grass and all that type of stuff. So we'll spend time more on the harvesting and mulching, a little less time on the grass mowing. But I do need to check, make sure the AI worker is not just, you know, lazing about doing nothing, costing us money. Did sell the eggs already today. Haven't sold milk yet. We'll probably get to that in a bit. As you can see, got some stuff out here set up to get this on our way. We need to get this field harvested, mulched, and then we need to plow it up to connect it to the sunflower field, which we're going to take the loss on the sunflower field, unfortunately, and get these fields all ready to be planted in with barley, because I think next month, July, August, is when we plant barley. Let's take a quick look. September is when we plant barley. So we have next month where we can probably do that plowing and maybe even some of that mulching. But we'll take a look here and see how this goes. I'm going to go ahead and get a good headlands going here on this field. Hopefully we'll get a good number on it, a good yield. That green looks pretty good down there, I think. So that's always a plus when we do harvest. Dropping straw. I forgot to check if we were dropping straw. That's good. We need some straw. We have 150,000 liters we got off the barley field. I think we have about 30 or 40 some thousand liters of straw left. Let's do a review as well, because I also think we had some baby piglets born, I believe. So we'll have to check on them as well. So I am going to crack on with, well, here, let's go ahead and do some of this. Let's check on baby piglets. Did we have baby piglets? Oh no, we don't have baby piglets. We have to wait 2 more months and we'll have baby piglets. I'm jumping the gun. Oh well. Sorry. I thought we were gonna have babies this month. But it'll be September we'll get some more baby piglets. And that will keep going. And then in 4 months we'll have 8, and then 4 more months we'll get like 12, and then it'll be like it'll just multiply fast because pigs have babies every 4 months, so it'll go fast. And I know we got some sunflowers in there. Hate the fact that we're gonna have to plow them under, but I think we need to connect this field to the barley. The barley's more important right now than those sunflowers are, and we need chickens. So yeah, I think I will crack on. Before I do, let's go ahead and check on our grass. Yeah, we want to stop that. And we want to definitely, I don't know why they put the sensor out. And we want to start them going this way. We'll just help them out a little bit. And we'll get them back to work. They'll have this field finished up pretty quick, then we'll have them work on this other small field here. Again, like I said, I don't know how we're going to do hay to silage. I haven't really looked at how much hay or silage we have. I know we're in pretty good shape, and I don't mind selling any of the extra that we may get. Because money is good. Good, good, good. Alright, set the worker back off. Get back here, and I think we're gonna have ourselves a bit of a time lapse here to start the show. So I'll see you guys all in a bit. back. This field, as you can see, well, or can't see, there we go. Field, as you can see, is completely done. So we need to get this straw baled up and get ourselves rolling. I have a worker making some hay. Have to check on them. I should check on them right now. All right, we'll just let them do what they're doing. I have no idea. They'll be done shortly. So we'll get this field done here. So some future stuff, as we talked about, we're going to buy that potato field. We're going to wait till the potato field is harvested. That way we can don't have to worry about harvesting it, because, you know, we don't have any potato equipment. Leasing it would be pricey and it would be time consuming to do. We will lease a plow here soon, probably next month, and we'll plow these two fields together. Our environmental score on this field was not that great. It was something around 79, and it said 0 for nitrogen. So I don't know if this field was over-fertilized, I don't know what's wrong with this field. So we're going to be sure, you know, to go through all the steps as usual when we prepare this field for barley. Hopefully it'll all be okay. All right, our worker is completed creating hay. I'm going to set that worker off to do some hay. Some more hay. I think we're only going to do a little bit of silage this month. We'll probably do a little bit more silage at the end of the year. We're pretty even on silage to hay. So I think I'm going to do hay on those two fields, and then I'll do silage on the smaller field that we have mowed by the barn. I think that'll be all right. We have, like I said, we'll do silage then at the end of the year. I don't know how much we'll have to sell, but we should have probably a little. We still have a little bit of silage in that tower. Depending on how much straw we get here, we might be able to make a little bit more silage. So I think we'll be okay. And again, selling, if we have anything to sell grass wise at the end of the year is bonus. We'll be turning out the jam production soon, so we'll get some jam to be sold, you know, at that second high point, along with obviously any crops that need to be sold at that time of year. I don't know if we'll have anything. It's like, we don't have any wheat. Barley we gotta keep. So do we have any crops that need selling? I think we sold them last month, right? Yeah, soybeans and corn. Yeah, we have nothing to sell. We only have barley and oat. And oat, as you can see, oats, we'll sell our oats in December. So with our, you know, it's at, what, 1,100 per 1,000, 26. So we'll get 26,000, 30-some thousand, you know, maybe 32,000 with the environmental score to go along with purchasing that field. Keep paying down our loan, selling our milk, selling our eggs. You know, we're going to be in pretty good shape. Very good shape we'll be in. So we'll get this field taken care of here real quick. Let me know down in the comments about your thoughts on if we should just keep waiting for a tractor to show up to replace the John Deere, or if we should maybe think about saving up money to buy a new one to replace the John Deere. Something with higher horsepower. I mean, that John Deere's got pretty good horsepower, but something equal or more. Also, you know what other type of equipment we might want to think about buying? I know we've talked about a telehandler type of thing or something like that as well. So let me know what your thoughts are. We do have some extra money. I think we're going to have some extra money after we buy that field. Maybe we'll be able to afford a second field, but I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments, as always. So, yeah, once we get this field set up, I will take us through some inventory, take us through the plan, just so we remember everything. Now that I'm not doing as many, like, I'm doing more videos a week, but not as many white farm videos per week. I'm trying to do one video of white farm, one quart farm, one summer run forest a week. Feels about right. And it might not even be that, because I'm doing, like, the next video I'll do is Silver Run, and Quart, Silver Run, and White. I'm just doing that because Silver Run is newer. There's a lot of different things that can be seen in those videos. And after a while, we'll probably fall back into a pattern of 1-1-1-1-1-1. But for now, that's how we're going to do it. It's going to be this will be a white farm, silver run, quart farm, silver run, white farm, and so on and so forth. I'm trying to get a little bit better at the consistency of releasing videos, trying to get them out more, same, you know, set of days, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, something like that. So how many did we get? Oh my goodness. Oh man, do we have any straw? Did I miss any straw anywhere? Just to finish it off. I guess we'll have to finish it off with a little bit of hay. That's alright. So once we finish this up, we will jump over and start doing some mulching. We'll mulch a little bit, set a worker, and then I'll probably finish up the video selling milk. Because milk needs to be sold every month. So here we are. I don't know if it's going to come out hay, straw. There's straw. And now it looks hay. All right. So we'll just shut this down for now. Let's go and get... this little bit here ate up. Alright. Nope. I'm full. We got more over here. I don't know why we do all of this. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, so I think this will all be like I'm showing. Is that not mowed over there? Didn't miss a mowing spot. I feel foolish when I do that, but it'll be alright. So yeah, so this is all hay over here, this will be all silage, and then maybe do another inventory at the end of the year. Let's see, so July, October, it's September, November, so it'll be November when we mow again. So we'll have to take supply and see what we'll need. cheddar in here. I already switched the mower over to do mulching. So that we can go ahead and mulch. Our field, we'll have to mulch the other field. Maybe we're not even turned on. What a waste. Oh well. So we're gonna go ahead and get this mulched. We'll mulch the other field. Probably not get it all on camera. Like I said, we have lots to do this month, and we still have to sell our milk. And I think I haven't showed selling milk in a while. Taking the milk up, giving it to dairy or wholesale or restaurant or wherever they need it. But I'd like to get a little bit of a border here. And because this field we're not going to plant until we do the soybeans. And I don't know if those, I don't know if it's March or April, but it'll be a while. But it needs the work done. And it's just nice to get the fields ready for planting. Whereas the other field, September. So we have a good deal of work to do on the farm, which is always good. There's more activity, better videos. Speaking of better videos, I've been trying to improve the audio quality of our videos, and I feel like it's gone in reverse. Last few videos, I think the audio has been all over the place. So the things that I've been trying haven't been successful. This one has been recorded how I usually record videos. So I think this video should be all right. But man, some of the others, the sound comes out just so quiet. Even if I crank it up in the mixing, when I'm mixing the video with the audio, it just doesn't get there. So I'm working on that. I'm trying to figure out a solution to get better audio to go with it. Another thing I've been thinking about is upgrading my Xbox to a better Xbox, which would only improve the video quality. But then again, at the end of the day, that'd still be a win. But I'm not quite there yet, so we'll see. Let me know down in the comments if you guys have a way that you would recommend capturing the audio. I've tried a few different things, just none of them have been better than this original method of just basic voice recording software with a headset. I was hoping I could do better. Let me know in the comments though if you guys have ideas on how to improve the audio that won't break the bank. And with that, I think what I'm going to do here is get this guy in position, this little worker off, jump in a tractor, and take us out to get milk delivered. See some pigs over there. Pigs will be another source of income, but they won't be a source of income for a while, unfortunately. But they will be income soon enough. Probably, I think it's at 24 months. Pigs, 25 months. You can start selling off your pigs in about 25 months. Why 25? Because they have their baby. And then you sell them. Alright, so let's go ahead and jump in a tractor that's not currently being used. Isn't that special? the heck? I love the physics on this game sometimes. Like, there's no way that would happen. You'd just hurt your barn. Bend out. Hydraulics. But let's go pick up the milk. I don't know how much. I know we have quite a bit of milk ready to be sold. Prices aren't too good today. Milk prices start to skyrocket next month, which is good. So yeah, we'll go pick up our milk and we'll get it sold. I think then we'll probably wrap up the video on that. So this barn held about 4,800 liters, almost 4,900. Let's go load up at the other barn. Alright, here we go. Oh, we still have a lot of baling to do this month. We'll do that all offline. You guys don't need to see it. We've seen baling plenty. So this should be completely full. It is 88,000 liters. I think we've left some milk behind in this barn, but that's alright. Like I said, next month prices jump. We gotta also start thinking about, as we get more and more cows, that this container won't be big enough. Where do we want to go? Milk. As you can see, August prices start going up, and then September they're really high. But for now, we are going to 1197 dairy. Super. Yeah, so I know we can fit about 15 to 20 more cows, which just means that much more milk. Of course, that means also that much more food. But I think we have enough. We'll be okay. I feel bad that we gotta lose all these sunflowers, but end of day, we need to make that deal right and get it correct. And having extra barley on hand is never a bad thing at all. So still think it's the right thing to do. Let me know in the comments if you think I should save the sunflowers or not. If I save the sunflowers, that means we just have less barley planted, and then we combine the two fields for the next barley growth. And I don't know if we can wait that long, because I don't know if we'll have enough barley to feed the chickens, but we can always buy chicken food if need be. So just let me know what you think. Come up here on dairy. Should get a pretty good sale here. As we sell our, there's about 1,100 per 1,000, so we have 8, so we'll have about 8,800 plus the environmental score. Yeah, so 9,583 plus 831 for the environmental score. So our environmental, like I said, it went down. So like we look here, this field went way down. This field went up though. This field, I don't know where it was at. Don't want to know. So if we look at, I have it on the field. Let's do that. We're at 79. I think we were in the 80s before we harvested this. So it brought us down. I want to get back into that 85. And I'm not sure how to get there. But we'll get there. So we have 266,000. The field we want to buy is 151,000, which isn't too bad. Unless we go here, which is 200 and 75,000. I don't think we'll get enough. I mean, we will get enough to get that field. But, and if we do get that field, then we can make this all one big cornfield. Maybe that's what we do. We try to save enough money to get this field. But yeah, we'll have to see. So let's first, we also have to pay back our loan. Let's pay back our loan first and foremost. All right, and then let's take it, our finances. So we sold 9,000 in milk. We sold 8,000 in egg. So 9,500 in milk, 8,500 in egg. Our environmental bonus was 1,700. We've so far shelled out 1,600 in wages. We're probably going to pay out some more because we have a worker going currently. So production costs, vehicle running costs. Yeah, let's go ahead and turn on our production, by the way. Or turn that one off because we can't fit any more herbicide. And then let's go. We don't have much water. Let's do that one. And then let's go ahead and turn our strawberries jam on. And there we go. So we need about, if we're making, if we're paying off 10 grand a month, and it's July, so we have 6 months left, so that's 60 grand that we're paying off. So that means we need to offset that 60 grand every month with milk and eggs, and that's fine. We'll be able to do that. So that kind of keeps us steady, which means we'll have to get some additional income, which would be like selling those oats will be a little bit of income. Maybe take on a contract or two here. Let's see. Contracts. There's a harvesting contract for barley in field 13. Big straight field. Maybe we'll take on that contract. How much was it paying? $3,800. Maybe. Rather do it for or a lime contract than that one for $3,800. Too much work for $3,800. Yeah, I think we're going to end the video here. Just want to say thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you are enjoying this channel, please think about subscribing. And also, thank you for spending time with us here at Fields and Skylines. And have yourself a great day. Goodbye.